Willie Fisher in his book, The Akhan, writes, his campaign for the Aligarh University required a final big heave, and as chairman of the fundraising committee, he went on a collecting tour through India's main Muslim areas. As a mendicant, he announced, I am now going out to beg from house to house and from street to street for the children of Indian Muslims. It was a triumphal tour. Wherever he went, people unharnessed of the horses of his carriage and pulled it themselves for miles. The response to the touching appeal of the Saraha Khan III was spontaneous. On his arrival at Lahore, the Daily Peace of Punjab editorially commented and called upon the Muslims to wake up, as the greatest personality and benefactor of Islam was in their city. The paper recalled a remark of Sir Syed Ahmad Khan prophesying the rise of a hand from the unseen world to accomplish his mission. That personality, the paper said, was of the Sir Aga Khan III. On that day, the London Times, commenting upon the visit, regarded him as a great recognized leader of Muslims. Allama Shibli Nomani was with Sir Aga Khan in the delegation for fundraiser to Lahore. Shibli recited a very passionate Persian poetry to motivate the audience for fundraiser. The significant aspect of the Aga Khan's fund collection drive was not the enthusiastic welcome accorded to him, but the house-to-house collection drive. Qayyumul Malik writes in his book, Prince Aga Khan, that once the Aga Khan on his way to Bombay to collect funds for the university, the Aga Khan stopped his car at the office of a person who was known to be his bitterest critic. The man stood up bewildered and asked, whom do you want, sir? I have come for your contribution to the Muslim University Fund, said the Aga Khan. The man drew up a check for rupees 5,000. After pocketing the check, the Aga Khan took off his hat and said, now, as a beggar, I beg from you something for the children of Islam, but something in the bowl of his mendicant. The man wrote another check for rupees 15,000 with moist eyes and said, Your Highness, now it is my turn to beg. I beg of you in the name of the most merciful God to forgive me for anything that I may have said against you. I never knew you were so great. The Aga Khan said, don't worry, it is my nature to forgive and forget in the cause of Islam and the Muslims.